Hello everyone, this is Mamta Mond and today we will learn and solve chapter 9. Chapter name is data handling. Questions 1 and 2 of chapter 9 data handling, exercise 9.1 of class 6 of NCERT mathematics textbook. If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for getting notifications of future videos. And please visit my blog massgrade.com. For more information regarding the textbook solution of CBSE, ICSE and other state boards. Let's get started and solve some questions. Today we learn and solve exercise 9.1, questions 1 and 2 of chapter data handling. Let's solve some questions. This is the questions. This is the question number 1 of exercise 9.1. In this image, the questions 1 of exercise 9.1 is given. The question is, in a mathematics test, the following marks are obtained for team students. Arrange the marks of the table using tally mark. These are the data. These are the data of the marks of the students given in numbers. And we have to first represent this data in a table form, that is the marks and the tally marks, and find out the number of students getting that particular mark. So arranging the marks in a table using the tally marks, this is the table we have to find out. This is the table we have to create, that the marks here 1, how many students getting, how many number of times the mark 1 is given here. This is 1 1, two times. So 1, the mark 1 is 2 times, that is the tally marks will be represented the 2 times the horizontal the vertical bar, that is, this is the 2 tally marks. The number 2 will be represented with in tally marks the 2 times the vertical bar. And the frequency is the number of times the students, number of students, how many students getting the marks 1. So number of student is getting the marks 1 is 1 1, 2 times. So the frequency, that is the number of students getting mark 1, is 2. This is a tally mark 1 and 1, so it is 2. Then 2, mark 2. How many students getting the mark 2? This is 2. 2 and 2. 3 times. So we have to represent the number 3 in tally marks as 3 bar, 3 line of bar. Horizontal bar. So 1 2 3, and the frequency, that is the number of students getting the mark 2, is 3. 1 2 3 1 2 3 3 bar. So you have to write 3, number 3, that is the number of students getting the mark 2. The number 3, how many students getting the mark 3? 1 2 2 times. 2 times. 1, 3 times. So number of students getting the mark 3 is 3 times. So we have to represent the tally marks with 3 horizontal, 3 vertical bar. So frequency, that is the number of students getting the mark 3, is 1, 2, 3, 3 bar. So number 3. Now number of students getting the mark 4. This is 4. 4. 4. 4. 4. 4. So number of students getting the mark for each 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7. So how to represent the number 7 in tally marks? So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, we have to draw 4 vertical bar. Then the number 5 will be just strike out. This is the number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, vertical bar. And number 5 is, this is the slanting line over this vertical bar. This is number 5, then 2. So we have to draw 2 vertical bar. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is slanting line representing the number 5. Then 5, then plus 1, 6. Then another vertical bar, 6. 6 and 7. 5 plus 2 is 7. So this is the number of frequency, that is the number of students getting the mark 4 is 7. Now how many students getting the mark 5? Five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So number of students getting the mark 5 is 5. 5 is 6. So we have to represent the tally marks. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 vertical bar. And the slanting line is for number 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Slanting is number 5, 5, then plus 1 more vertical bar, that is 5 plus 1 is 6. So the number of students getting the mark 5 is 6, that is number 6. Now how many students getting the mark 7? This is 7, 7, 7. 7, number 7. So number of students getting the mark 7 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, so 5 will be represented in tally marks there. Will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 vertical lines, vertical bar, and the slanting line that is represent the number 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and number slanting line is the number 5. So the number of students getting mark 7 is 5. Now how many students getting the mark 8? Number 8. So total number of students getting mark 8 is 4. So we have to represent tally marks will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 vertical bar. So it is represented with 4 vertical bar. So number is frequency of the number of frequency, that is the number of students getting mark 8 is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now number of students getting mark 9. How many students getting mark 9? This is number 9. 1. Number 9. 9. 3. So number of students getting mark 9 is 3. So we have to represent tally marks 3 vertical line, 3 vertical bar, that is 1, 2, 3. So number of students getting mark 9 is 3. This is the table that is representing the marks and the tally marks and the finding the frequency, that is the number of students getting that particular mark. Now we have to find the question number 1. The question is 1A is find how many students obtained marks equal to or more than 7. We have to find out the number of students getting the mark equal to or more than 7. So number of students getting marks equal to or more than 7 will be 7. This is mark 7. So number of students getting mark 7 is 5. And number of students getting equal to 7 and more than 7, that will be 7, 8 and 9. So number of students getting mark 8 is 4. And number of students getting mark 9 is 3. So total number of students getting obtained the marks equal to or more than 7 will be marks. Number of students getting mark 7 is 5. The number of students getting mark 8 is 4. 5 plus 4. The number of students getting mark 9 is 3. So 5 plus 4 plus 3, that is 12. So number of students obtained marks equal to or more than 7 is 12. Now we have to solve question number 1B question. B teach how many students obtain marks below 4. We have to find the number of students obtain marks below 4. So below 4 will be 3, 2, 1. Below 4 mark will be 3, 2, 1. So number of students getting mark 3 is 3. Number of students getting mark 2 is 3. 3 plus 3. And number of students getting mark 1 is 2. 2. 3 plus 3 plus 2 is 8. So total number of students getting marks obtained. Number of students obtained marks below 4. Below 4 will be 3 plus 3 plus 2, that is 8. So answer is 8. Now question number 2. Question number 2 given is following is the choice of sweets 30 students of class 6. Laddu, barfi, laddu, jalebi, laddu, rasgulla. Laddu, jalebi, laddu, barfi, rasgulla. Laddu, jalebi. Jalebi, rasgulla, laddu, rasgulla, jalebi, laddu. Rasgulla, laddu, laddu, barfi, rasgulla, rasgulla. Jalebi, rasgulla, laddu, rasgulla, jalebi, laddu. And these are the data of the sweets. The choice of sweets of 30 students in class 6. First, we have to represent this. And the question is arrange the names of sweets in a table using tally marks. So we have to arrange these names of the sweets in tally marks. This is the table laddu. The sweet laddu, the number of students prefer the sweets laddu. How many times the laddu is given here? 1, laddu, 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 laddu. So total number of students prefer the sweet laddu is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So number of students prefer sweet laddu is 11. So we have to represent this number 11 in tally marks. How to represent the number 11 in tally marks? In the previous questions, that is, we have to draw first 1, 2, 3, 4. This is number 4 in vertical line. Then we have to draw the slanting line, that is representing the number 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, this is slanting line number 5, then 1, 2, 3, 4 and slanting line. This is also number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 plus 5, 10. Then single horizontal, single vertical line. That is for 1. Then 5 plus 5 plus 1. This is number 11. Now, how many students prefer the sweet barfi? First, we have to find out the number of barfi given. Barfi, 3 barfi. So, we have to represent the tally marks. 3 barfi will be 3 vertical line, and this is the number 3. So, number of students prefer barfi is 3. Now, the jalebi, the sweet jalebi, how many students prefer jalebi? How many times jalebi is given here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, number of students prefer jalebi is 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, how to represent the number 7? 1, 2, 3, 4. This is number 4 vertical lines. Then the slanting line. This is for number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 1 more 6. 1 more line for 6. 5 plus 1, 6. Then 1 more line for 7. 5 plus 2 is 7. So number of students prefer jalebi is 7. Then rasgulla. How many students prefer rasgulla? First we have to find out how many times the rasgulla is given here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So number of times the rasgulla, number of students prefer rasgulla is number 9. How to represent number 9 in tally marks? First 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the number 4 vertical lines for 1, 2, 3, 4. Then this is the slanting line for number 5, then plus 1, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Another 4 vertical lines. So number 5 and plus 4, number 9. So number of students prefer rasgulla is number 9. This is the table for representing the tally marks and the number of students prefer the different sweets. Now we solve question number 2nd bit B. Which sweet is preferred by most of the students? We have to find out the most of the students, that is more number of students prefer the particular sweet. So from this table we find out that the laddu, the number of students prefer laddu is 11, number of students prefer barfi is 3, number of students prefer jalebi is 7 and number of students prefer rasgulla is 9. From these tables we see that the number of students 11 prefer laddu, that is the most. So our answer will be the sweet that is preferred by most of the student is laddu, having the 11 number of students preferred it. So, the sweet that is preferred by most of the students is laddu. So, the laddu sweet is preferred by most of the students. And my favorite sweet is rasgulla. And tell me what is your favorite sweet from this laddu, barfi, jalebi and rasgulla. What is your favorite sweet? Tell me in the comment section. Laddu, barfi, jalebi or rasgulla.
If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel. And if you have any doubt, then please write in comment section and I will reply. Keep learning, keep watching, and please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.